step to Christ, rejoicing in the Lord. If we keep uppermost in our minds the unkind and unjust acts of others, we shall find it impossible to love them as Christ has loved us. But if our thoughts dwell upon the wondrous love and pity of Christ for us, the same spirit will flow out to others. We should love and respect one another, notwithstanding the faults and imperfections that we cannot help seeing. Humility and self-distrust should be cultivated, and a patient tenderness with the faults of others. This will kill out all narrowing selfishness and make us large-hearted and generous. The psalmist says, "Trust in the Lord and do good, so shalt thou dwell in the land, and verily thou shalt be fed." Psalm 37 verse 3. Trust in the Lord. Each day has its burdens, its cares and perplexities, and when we meet, how ready we are to talk of our difficulties and trials. So many borrowed troubles intrude, so many fears are indulged, such a weight of anxiety is expressed, that one might suppose we have no pitying, loving Savior, ready to hear all our requests and to be to us a present help in every time of need. Some are always fearing and borrowing trouble. Every day they are surrounded with the tokens of God's love. Every day they are enjoying the bounties of His providence, but they overlook these present blessings. Their minds are continually dwelling upon something disagreeable which they fear may come, or some difficulty may really exist which, though small, blinds their eyes to the many things that demand gratitude. The difficulties they encounter, instead of driving them to God, the only source of their help, separate them from Him because they awaken unrest and repining. Step to Christ, page 121.